This is seriously like the most colorful I have ever been in my entire freaking life. But you know what? My dark soul isn't hating it because I think I found my winning color. Hi everyone, my name is Holly, and in today's video I'm going to be doing my May book haul, and I'll be unboxing the May Beacon book box, which includes the next exclusive Lunar Chronicles dust jacket, which is going to be scarlet, so you don't want to miss that. So like usual, I'm going to start with the books that were sent to me this month, which I'm always so grateful for. And Orbit sent me 4 books. They were very generous, and the first one that was sent to me was The 10,000 Doors of January by Alex Iharo. Now, I did not expect to get this book. It's not one that I've been eyeing or anticipating, but when Orbit offered it up to me, I was like, eh, why not? I'll give it a shot. And I just finished it today, and I'm obsessed. This is a YA fantasy historical fiction, which I don't normally read historical fiction, so I'm still quite shook by this. It releases on September 10th, so mark your calendars, and it explores the idea that doors are portals between one world and another. It follows our main character who lives in this huge mansion that is owned by a billionaire archaeologist, and one day she stumbles upon a book that is called The 10,000 Doors, and it basically states that bending physical laws of the universe is possible. I don't want to go any farther than that because I will be talking about this way more in my May wrap-up, but just know this is a new favorite. The next book I have here is Velocity Weapon by Megan E. O'Keefe. This is a new sci-fi series that comes out on June 11th, and it's a space opera, and it follows our main character Sanda, who wakes up 230 years in the future on a sentient ship called Burrow, and that ship tells her that the war is over and that the entire star system is dead. What happens now? Because I need to know. This is apparently full of space battles and intergalactic politics and rogue AI. The story is told from different points of views in different timelines, so it has a lot of complexity and depth to it. I'm so excited about this one. In fact, I feel like this is the type of plot that I will gobble up in a day. It sounds really addictive. In fact, I'm already addicted to it and I haven't even read it. The next book that Orbit sent me was The Games House by Claire North, and this one comes out on May 28th. This book is actually 3 shorter novels all rolled into one, and I'm so happy that Orbit decided to pick it up and publish it as one book because I think the story sounds really unique and original. It basically centers around this gambling house where the deadly games of chance and skill control the fate of the empires. That sounds freaking awesome. Each story takes place in a different time period, which has me so curious on how they all intertwine together. And even though this is totally out of my element, I'm a medieval sword and sorcery kind of girl. I'm so intrigued by the premise of these real world games having all too real consequences. And the final book that the lovely people from Orbit sent me was Frey by Rowena Miller, and this one comes out on June 4th, and it's the sequel to Torn, which came out last year, which has an incredibly unique magic system all about sewing charms into clothing. The series has a lot of political intrigue, and it's kind of set in this 18th century like country. In fact, I feel like if you like historical fiction fantasy with a touch of romance, then you'll really enjoy it. And obviously it's an added bonus with those magical elements to it. And the last book that was sent to me from Sourcebooks was this beautiful hardcover edition of King's Bane by Claire Legrand. I actually hauled the arc of it a couple months ago, and this book just recently came out on the 21st, so if you would like to continue this world, you can go ahead and do that. This is the sequel to Furyborn. There's really not a whole lot to say about this series. It's very well hyped, and I'm sure you've heard about it a million times, so I won't go on any further. I will say that this series overall is just really good eye candy, and sometimes that's just all you need. Now on to the books that I bought myself this month, and there are only 4, so I was very reserved this month. In fact, most of these I will be reading in June, so go me. No buyer's remorse in this house. So the first 2 books I have here go together, and the first one being Stranger the Tempest by Tom Lloyd, and then the second one I have here is Princess of Blood. So I mentioned in my last video, it was 8 upcoming fantasy books that you guys might not have heard about, and I mentioned that Tom Lloyd has a brand new series coming out next month or July, I forget, but it's called Night of Stars. I'll post a picture. But this new book takes place in this series, and it's even going to have the same characters, so I want to read them all in order and get myself caught up. So I decided to buy this duology. I guess I should hold them up like this. This is an adult epic fantasy that sounds like it could possibly be one of my new favorites because it's all about a band of mercenaries, my favorite trope of all time. And I mean, these books alone, which I'm going to give you close-ups, obviously, there is no dust jacket. This artwork is on the book. By the way, the scene totally reminds me of Lord of the Rings, just saying. And then we have the second book, which is the same, no dust jacket. And it looks like we have like a giant ice spider or roach or something, and I am so intrigued. You know what? Let me just read you the first sentence because it had me hooked immediately. For a damsel in distress, she was rather more spattered with someone else's blood than Lynx had expected, and naked, very naked. I obviously need to read this immediately, which I feel like is gonna happen in June. The next book here is King of Fools by Amanda Foody. I read the first book, Ace of Shades, this month, and I really enjoyed it. And since this book literally just came out on April 30th, I believe, which I'm very lucky I don't have to wait at all to read a sequel, I decided to pick it up. So this is another book that I will definitely be reading next month, and I just love Amanda Foody as a person, and I love her stories and her writing. I really enjoyed Daughter of the Burning City, so I'm constantly seeing what she's going to come up with next. This series basically centers around a city called New Rains, and it's a very dark and grimy city full of casinos and just shady activity in general, and I found it really fun. It's definitely more character driven. There's not a whole lot of plot that happens, but I just enjoyed it overall for the characters. And the final book that I have here is actually a graphic novel, and I'm so happy that I have it in my hands because it was a pre-order, and that is Rat Queen Volume 6 by Curtis J. Weeb. Rat Queens has been one hell of a roller coaster for me, from absolutely loving it and then not really liking where the story went. But I have heard such good things about this volume in particular, and I am just hoping that Curtis somehow brought the story back to how it began. Just be fun and full of adventure. I have also seen images of great representation in this, of a very curvy character that's not seen as sad and ugly, but as beautiful. So I am so excited to delve into this. In fact, by the time this video goes up, I have probably already read this, so maybe keep an eye out for that wrap up again. And the artwork here is also looking pretty good. Alrighty, so that is it for all of the books that I hauled in May. Now let's go ahead and go on to the May Beacon Book Box. You can use my code HOLLY10 on your very first subscription. I highly recommend it, like always. I'm so excited to see this Scarlet exclusive dust jacket. I'm sure it's right on top. Yes, it is. So the theme for this month was Layers of Magic, and I feel like the best way for me to show you this dust jacket is just to go ahead and put it on the book, so it'll be a lot easier to show you. So let me do that. Okay, so obviously you guys already know what Scarlet looks like, and here it is. Oh my goodness. Okay, so Scarlet was actually my least favorite book out of the Lunar Chronicles series, but I still really, really enjoyed it. It's probably still like a 4-star read for me. But oh my goodness, this is so pretty. We have Scarlet here, we have Wolf Boy here, and then we also have the spine, which the spines are going to say the Lunar Chronicles, which is going to be so pretty when it's all collected together. And then we have the back, which just shows like a moon, and then like the little Red Riding Hood cloak. Oh, it's so pretty. I'll just give you a nice close-up even more. Oh yeah. Up next, I have a candle from Novel Yours. It says King of Scars. It's going to smell like citrus, must, and sandalwood. All right, let's test it out. Okay, so this smells exactly like my boyfriend's shower gel, and I'm not hating it. Yes! Oh, Beacon Book Box, you just saved my freaking life. So I am sick and tired of getting bath bombs in book boxes. So They included a shower steamer, which is inspired by the Remnant Chronicles, one of my like all-time favorite YA fantasy series. And that's what it looks like. It says Kingdoms of Morrigan. And does it say what it's gonna smell like? Ocean air and dark woods. I can't really smell it through the packaging, but I'm so excited to use this. I've never used a shower steamer before, but I've heard about them, and I keep hoping that someone includes it in a book box, and it's Beacon Book Box that does it first. At least when I got one anyways. Up next, we have some loose tea by the Simply Bookish Co. And it says Magnus Demora. And it's going to taste like black citrus tea. That's what the label looks like. And also the back as well. Ooh, the book sleeve is so pretty. But I'm going to show you that last. So like usual, we have the monthly Baking with the Beacons recipe, which is Katza's cinnamon roll sugar cookies, which sounds so freaking good. And then we have a print, which is inspired by Caraval by Stephanie Garber, that says some things are worth pursuit regardless of the cost, which is really pretty. Alrighty, so now we have gotten to the best part, and that is the book sleeve and the book. So the book sleeve is Harry Potter inspired, which is so cool. It's like stained glass with all of the houses. So we have Gryffindor, Ravenclaw, Hufflepuff, and Slytherin. And the book is inside, and I believe I know exactly what it is. And I believe it's a book that I have already read. I guess we'll see in a moment. It is. This is Romanov by Nadine Brandis, and I have already read this. I liked it. I think I gave it 3 out of 5 stars, but I am really happy to have a finished copy that is signed as well. So that is super cool. It's so pretty. I had the art paperback, and this hardcover is gorgeous. What does it look like underneath? Oh, it's just plain black. Dang it! This is a Anastasia retelling with magical elements, and like I said before, I really enjoyed it. So check this one out. And that's it for this unboxing. Like I said before, use my code HOLLY10 on your very first subscription. The next box, June's box, is going to have the Crest exclusive dust jacket, which I'm so hyped for. Crest was my favorite out of the whole series, so I can't wait to see what that one's gonna look like. And that is it for this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed. Go ahead and give this video a big thumbs up because it helps me out so much. And don't forget to subscribe. I upload videos every single week, and follow me on Twitter at HollyNeese and on Instagram at HollyHeartsBooks. And until we meet again, happy reading.